Hello, my friend, and welcome to my channel. Today I've got Superchic Lacquer, Queen of Tea. I'm doing a Peacock Mani. I started off with Peeleze as my base coat, Superchic's Queen of Tea. I'm going to do the first coat. My base coat is already on there and nice and dry. I have sped this whole video up about 1.5 times and cut out any of the gobbledygook that we didn't need to see. I'm being sure to cap my free edge there. And now I'm going to go in with my second coat of Queen of Tea. This is a beautiful green holo. I am in love with it. I'm using the Superchic Top Coat, the Maveral Liquid Macro Top Coat. I saved this one to use only over my Superchic Lacquer polishes. I know, I'm funny like that. So, can be sure to cap that free edge again. Hi, Woody, how you doing? I'll be using this Queen Animal Safari plate today. I don't remember the number. It's crazy. My Funky Fingers, Dark Knight, and my Conad Stampers and the Conad Scrapers going to be used today. So that is the Queen Animal Safari 01 plate. And here we go. We're going to roll. And look at that pickup. It's just gorgeous. I'm also going to use this other image that just looks like a bunch of the peacock feathers. Because today I'm going to just do two accent fingers. I know, y'all got to be confused. Where's Tina? She's not doing all of them. I'll be using this China Glaze DV8 and China Glaze IDK to fill in my, I'm making decals. So reverse stamping today, y'all. I'm just loving these colors. You know, I got a couple of collections. I got the Superchic collection and the China Glaze OMG collection in, and I'm just trying to make sure that I use all of them somehow, some way, really quick before they get lost up in the collection because they're gorgeous. I am fixing to, and I know that's a southern thing, I'm fixing to start trying to really utilize these polishes and break out some untrieds. There might be some videos where I'm using really old polishes or old collections or, you know, things that have long been since discontinued that I've never used. I bought them, had to have them, bought them. And they have sat unloved, and I'm gonna work on changing that. But as you can see, I'm just using a little dotting tool, and I'm not really following, like, the lines. I'm not staying in the lines very well. But for my abstract eye, this is going to work out just fine. I'm just filling it in with the blue and the purple holo. I've got one fancy peacock going on here, y'all. But I really was looking forward to this one. This is a mani that, as soon as I saw those polishes, especially that green one, I knew it had to. I had to do a peacock. Now that just showed you, you gotta be careful doing this dotting because I almost scraped off the design underneath. So be light-handed, not like Tina, heavy-handed. Try to be light-handed when you do these. Flipping it over, checking it out. It's looking pretty good. We're gonna keep on going. And I'm going to dot in some of the blue and then some of the purple down here on its chest area. Get that thing looking pretty like a peacock. Love, love watching peacocks. They're just so cool. We used to go to the zoo quite often when our youngins was little, and I always loved seeing the peacocks because they just roamed our whole zoo. They'd be just all over the place, walking all proud and pretty and talking. Of course, they're very loud. You know, I wouldn't want one as a pet because they're very, very loud. And this one's the peacock feather image, and I just, it just looks like a whole bunch of peacock feathers just stacked up. So I just thought this one would be a really good one. I'm, you know, working on breaking outside of even my normal crazy square. Get out of the box. I've decided to go ahead and break out that Robin Moses brush, the wand. I've had people ask, is it any good? I don't have a lot of experience with detail brushes or, you know, nail art brushes. I own a bunch of them, but I don't use them often because I don't do very much freehand because I'm not really good at it. As this video right here shows, I'm just not really good at that detailed stuff. I know a lot of people that have gotten this Robin Moses brushes or brush have trimmed them down, and I just can't bring myself to do that, so because I'm scared I'm gonna mess it up, and so I'm just gonna use it the way it is. Maybe one day I'll get brave, I don't know. So I'm gonna go in and fill in around these purple blobs with some blue blobs. Say that 3 times fast. Whew. And I might be talking a little fast, and I think it's because I've sped this video up so much that I'm trying to keep up with it. Crazy girl. But I do like this brush. You know, this, I think this is like the second or third time I've used it, and I do really like it. Like I said, I've got a lot of brushes I've bought off of eBay and AliExpress, and, you know, when I bought this brush, I actually bought the set. I bought it mostly to support Robin, because Robin is an amazing teacher. She has given so much to the nail art community that when she put those brushes up on her store, I had to have them because I wanted to support her. I do that with a lot of my friends that I've made here on YouTube. Now, I'm not personally in touch with Robin. She doesn't watch my videos and leave me comments, but, you know, I know she supports what I'm doing because she supports all of us nail artists. And I've decided to go ahead and just take that purple and roll over the whole thing. Now, I want you to see how this polish is. It's kind of funky. It's like a jelly. It wants to pull on itself. Now, I remember when I did the road test of these polishes, I was talking about supposedly they had a better formula. I'm not 100% convinced on that. I don't know. We'll talk about it more later. But I'm applying the Smudge Free Top Coat to this decal because I want that black to stick when I go to, you know, transfer it over to my nail from the stamper. And I didn't want it to smear that black. So I've let that dry for just a little bit. I wanted it tacky, not wet. And then I'm applying it to the nail. I'm going to take my finger around and mush it down real good. I'll be using my cuticle pusher tool from Sally's to kind of break that decal up a little bit to get the excess off. I have another tool that I want to try for this. I just didn't, you know, with wet nails, I don't want to go digging through stuff trying to dig it out and mess something up. So we'll try to remember to use that next time. This one works pretty good. I mean, as you can see, it is doing the job, but I'm having to be very careful. This is normally where I mess these manis up, trying to get that decal trimmed and off my nail. Even if I use just acetone and try to go around, I still end up, see, there we go, I'm trying to mess it up. Put that thing back down there and do some more pushing, girl. There we go. Just, there we go. Pretty good. Not as bad as some. I'm going to go in with my acetone and my cleanup brush and try to melt the decal down onto the sides of the nail and clean up, you know, anything that I don't want. But mostly it's to get this decal to stick. And I'm going around. Now, on the end, I do go up under it really well. This is a big pet peeve of mine. Not on other people, but for me, I can't stand anything clumpy up under my nails. So I do go in and clean that up rather well. So look how pretty. Isn't that great? I love it. Now for the peacock feather image. Just gonna plunk that down and mush it down with my finger just like I did the other one. And just like the other one, I'm gonna use that little tool to kind of, you know, get some of this excess decal off. I just like this method of getting that excess off, rather than trying to get it all off with just my cleanup brush and the acetone. It just makes such a mess. And y'all know I don't mind cleanup. Cleanup's kind of therapeutic. but I don't want to be sitting there for a really long time cleaning up. I don't need that much therapy. Now I'm going to go in with my cleanup brush, just like the other one, and I'm going to melt that in. You see me just kind of using the side of the brush and tapping it up on that excess overhang. And then I wipe it on my paper towel. Gotta get that off my brush so I don't smear it on other parts of my finger. Well, I can tell you that in the end, I really loved this manicure. I guess because I wanted it, you know, I wanted those beautiful colors all together. To me, they're like gem colors or something, you know, those really pretty, just flashy colors. I love them. Green is just insane. And then to add the purple and blue to it, it made my day. I'm just going to tell you straight up, it made my day. I loved this manicure. I'll be using that smudge-free top coat again to go over both of these decals, because the side that's up on the nail sticking up right now has not had any top coat or anything on it. That was what was, you know, flat on the stamper. So I definitely want to make sure I'm not smearing that after all this work or play. Depends on how you look at it. Hi, Woody. Back again, I see. How you doing? And now we're going to go in with my top coat, my final top coat, my Poshe, and seal this one in. Just give it a final sealing. And I've got kind of a smudge on the side of that one. I don't know what I did, but it's so busy. Can't nobody tell but us nail junkies. And Woody's back for more. Camera hog. No, I'm just kidding. You know he's my bud. So there we go. That is my manicure. Here's my swatch photo. I hope you enjoyed this one. Please leave me a comment down below. I always love talking to you. Thanks for watching, and until next time, be good to yourself.